Welcome back to Shop Talk. We're talking to entrepreneurs in the leather bag business. With us now is Bianca Donato. She's the owner of the School of Satchel. And I've seen this in a lot of the bazaars, yes. Actually.
I'm active in bazaars.
Welcome to the show. Because I guess the Satchel is a very specific looking bag.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, but let's talk about your history first. You were abroad for a while.
Yes.
You were working in marketing.
Yes.
You decided to come home.
Yes.
And start this business.
Exactly.
Why bag business?
I wasn't really thinking of specifically bags. I was thinking of leather.
Okay.
I wanted to work with leather because...
Why is that?
Because when you feel or see a really good leather bag, it evokes a sense of luxury or power.
Right.
And when you travel with something made of really good quality leather or even wool, I also use wool for some of my items. You know that your items are always safe and... which is really important when you travel abroad or,
right.
or locally.
But I guess with leather, people always assume that it's maybe imported.
Mm-hmm.
Do you find that that is the case?
Yes, yes. Even during bazaars, I always get that question. Is this made here? Is this made? Are the leather sourced locally? And they're always surprised to hear that the leathers that I used is sourced only here.
As well.
Yes, exactly.
It's quite sad that they have to assume that it's made elsewhere just because it's so well made. But
yes.
We have so many good craftsmen here.
Yes, exactly. It's sad, but it's actually good that the local leather makers are educate
them jobs, right.
And that we can educate the customers as well about the leather industry here in the Philippines, that we actually have good leather craftsmen here.
But this is a one-man show for you, right?
Yes.
So talk us through the process of you starting it up, because you started it up last year.
I started,
And this is your what number collection? Is this your first collection?
The ones here, the satchels are my first collections, and the one in front, they're my second collection, which I only launched this month.
And what made you start with a satchel? I asked you that a while ago, but why the satchel first?
The satchel first because I was actually inspired by a few things while I was traveling abroad.
Okay.
And this design is very classic. It can take you from
day to night. Right.
You can also use it during travel or even working.
May I open one?
Yes, of course.
Okay. And your price range, because this is pure leather, right?
It's pure leather.
So what are your price ranges for this?
This one's 3,500.
This was from the first collection.
Yes.
Yes.
But this one's a new color.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you don't stick to the safe colors either. I think people are more adventurous now in terms of choosing. This is nice, because the crossbody, I guess, it makes you do more.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it's for the woman on the
go,
really.
Some women, they use it as a clutch as well.
Okay. And then you decided to venture out into more designs, and I even see things for travel.
Exactly.
The passport.
The passport
holder.
Folio, that's we call that our smart passport folio.
Okay.
It has a lot of pockets for your membership cards, your passport, and there's also two SIM card holders in the front, so you'll never lose your SIM cards while traveling.
Well, that's an important development.
It's a welcome innovation.
Since it's just you, are you the one who designs it, or do you come up with a team and talk about it with other people, what people need?
A team of one, that's me.
It's just really all you.
I do ask a few people, especially my customers, my previous customers, to and ask them what they think of my new designs,
right.
the new stuff that's coming out. So I do ask a lot of people about their opinions.
And who do you find is your clientele for something like this? Because it's a very specialized sort of bag, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who do you find is your clientele?
They're mostly professionals or people who are starting to find their new profession. So, from 24 to over 40 or 50 even.
Okay, and do you find that the fan base is growing? Because we were talking about it a while ago.
Yes.
And leather, much as it's so beautiful and it smells great, it's still a bit pricey.
Yes, it has been growing. For the first collection, I noticed that most of my customers were really women.
Okay.
And then I wanted to make something for the men as well, because when they go to the bazaars, they don't usually find anything for themselves. They just go there for their wives, for their sisters, for their girlfriends.
Or women who go to bazaars looking for Christmas presents for the men.
Yes.
And this is perfect,
and this
right?
is exactly it. That's why I launched a second collection, those things.
Okay, maybe we can talk about the beautiful... Would you call that a weekender bag?
Exactly. That's a weekend bag. It's made of nubuck leather, which is a top grain leather.
Okay.
And then the canvas material is actually wool.
Okay.
And then inside it's made of suede.
Wow.
It has a suede lining. And it also features an outside side pocket for easier access for your cameras and, you know, little things that you need.
You'd say that was unisex, right?
Yes. It comes in three colors.
Okay.
It also comes in military green and then light green.
And what's the price point for
that
something like that?
That one is 5,500.
And then for the... What would you call this?
That one is actually, it's a three,
belt bag,
yes,
right?
It's a three-way bag.
Okay.
So you can use it as a belt bag.
Okay. Yeah. And so it's quite interesting. And it's a two-tone sort of leather,
isn't it? This is nubuck. Mm-hmm. And then the other side is made of a different type of leather.
Okay.
So it's
a three-way, you
three-way
said.
Three-way, because you can use it as a belt bag,
right,
as a body bag.
Okay.
In here, and then as a small backpack as well.
Okay.
And then as you'll notice, the zipper is actually inside. It's inside the...
so it faces protects here. From people
exactly.
who want to pickpocket
exactly.
people.
So
and how much would
traveling.
Something like this be?
That one is 3,500.
Okay, well, it's pretty reasonable, mm-hmm. actually. But what are the pros and cons for you of working with leather? It's not the easiest thing to work with.
It's not.
And yet, it lasts.
Exactly. That's actually that's one of the major advantages. It's pricier, but you get what you pay for.
Okay.
So... all the products here are really meant to last you a lifetime. So even if you buy it while you're still studying in college, you can still use it while you're working or even later on, and you can even hand it down to your children.
Okay.
So that's what we really value, quality.
True. But on the business side, you went from marketing to doing this all on your own.
Yes.
What were some of the growing pains for you?
Well,
is it still happening?
Of course. Every day. Every day. I guess self-motivation, that's really important. Sometimes there are days when it's very tempting to not do anything.
Right.
But then you have to think about the bigger picture, why you're doing this. And then I think that's the main motivation, really, is that I really wanted to create global recognition for local products or local manufactured products. And slowly but surely, we're starting to get there.
What are the three lessons? Maybe the top three lessons
top
that
three
you've
lessons.
Learned.
Well,
pop quiz.
Yeah,
or maybe one or two.
Okay.
For those out there, because you know, it's so nice to see people who change professions mainstream and are very successful at it.
Yep. Well, it's a combination of maybe prayer and hard work.
Prayer always, almost always works, isn't it?
But seriously, it's. I think you always have to stay true to the values of your brand.
Okay.
So with SOS, we're obsessed with quality, with delivering something world-class to the Filipinos. So it's really important for entrepreneurs to make sure that their products are always consistent, that every piece is really of beautiful quality, something that you can be proud of, and something that you would wear yourself.
Right.
And secondly, we always value relationships as well. So
it's the people aspect of the business, which is really more important,
yes.
isn't it?
I always make it a point. SOS, we mostly sell online.
Okay.
But I make it a point to join bazaars, not only to market the products, but to also get to know the people that I communicate with online or even speak over the phone. A lot of them are really, really loyal patrons of the product.
Right. And it personalizes the business.
Yes, exactly.
I guess they feel that they can go to you anytime
exactly,
for anything.
Yeah. It puts a face behind the, you know, the website or the brand. So it's
okay.
Really nice.
So maybe you can tell us exactly where we can get it's called SOS, right?
SOS,
School of
yes,
Satchel.
Which stands for the School of Satchel. Please do visit my website. It's theschoolofsatchel.multiply.com. You can purchase your SOS products there. It's all fully automated. I accept PayPal, credit card, bank deposit, and GCash as well. Also available at Trinoma Analog Seoul, Alabang Town Center, and Spruce in Cagayan de Oro, and also in Red Dot Lawag.
Wow,
yes.
You've spread your wings really far.
Yes, I
Bianca,
try.
All the best.
Thank
and
you
congratulations
so much.
Thank once
you.
Again to the School of Satchel.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schultz. Follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Enjoy the rest of your day.